Just one more feature.
In this video, I'll show you how I set up my Unity project to get it ready to be organized and maintainable and scalable. I'll show you how to get started with your Unity project in this video. Nearly 20 years as a programmer, and I still scour the internet trying to look for the best game architecture I can find. I still try to make my code as organized and maintainable and scalable as possible so that when I add new features down the line or design plans change, it doesn't ruin and topple and break everything. So in this video, I want to talk about how I set up my projects, and I would like hopefully people to share how they set up their projects. I'll learn what I can, and then I'll share what I can, and we'll all hopefully get better. So how do I set up my code and project to be clean and organized so that when I'm adding new features on the fly, things don't become too cumbersome to manage? This is one of many videos in my series on game architecture. I'll talk about lots of things like how to set up a scene management system in Unity, how to do character state design patterns. I'll talk about how to do an audio system. I'll talk about how to use GitHub and how to best practices with a team. So if you're interested in that, make sure to check out my channel and subscribe and like this video. So game architecture is the structures and systems that you use to build your game. It's the organizational patterns and tools that you use so that things are quickly recognizable at a glance so that you can spend less time figuring out how your code works. You might be able to look at a line of code and understand how it works in the larger system. It helps you keep your classes small and maintainable, meaning when you go to add new things, you're not looking through thousands of lines of code. You're looking through maybe 100 lines of code, and you know how this 100 lines of code integrates into the larger system. And so you know that when you add this new thing, you know how it's going to affect the rest of your game. It also makes it easier for debugging, because when something breaks, you only really have to go to one spot. You can go to just that one class or that one small area of code to have to make changes to fix whatever bug you have. So a big part of your game architecture is the decisions you make in setting up and organizing your project. Clarity in how you name things, or conventions you use, or standards you have, or best practices your team follows will help your entire team stay more efficient. You'll all be on the same page so that when one person adds new code or new content, the rest of the team will understand easily how that's integrated into the rest of the system. If you all follow the same general rules or the same general standards, it makes it so your team can stay organized and cohesive as the project progresses. So good game architecture really helps threefold then. It helps you because it helps you understand your own systems. People talk about make sure to leave a lot of good comments so that when you come back to a project 6 months down the line, you can understand what's happening. But really, if you have good game architecture, the amount of comments you need is cut down. You can have things be a lot clearer by having clean code than by having a bunch of miscellaneous comments that you have to read and still kind of figure out what's happening. If you have good design patterns and good game architecture to begin with, good organization to begin with, you can quickly jump into projects, older projects, and understand what's happening at a glance, or at least faster. It also helps your team do the same exact thing. Because good game architecture helps you make code that's maintainable and organized, and so that you can add new things later, you can do things like adding a more robust tutorial system that will show off and showcase your mechanics and have them communicated clearer to your player. So a good game architecture could allow you to have a better game design and give your player a better experience. So after stumbling through numerous game prototypes, I got sick of recreating the same folders over and over. So I created a Unity plugin to create my folder hierarchy structures using scriptable objects and re-import them into every new project. I made that project an open source project on GitHub, and the link will be in the description if anybody is interested in checking it out. Something you could do to help me out is if you like the new folder wizard, give it a star on GitHub. Every Unity project is different, so not every project is going to have the exact same folder hierarchy or folder structure. But generally, this is how I set up my project. I start with an art assets folder, which will have everything that will be basically front-end display to my user. So that's things like fonts or images or materials or models or even things like Text Mesh Pro I put in there. I have an audio folder that I put obviously the audio files, but I also put in my mixers and my scriptable object audio events that I'll talk about in a later video when I do my audio system with scriptable object based events. In the editor folder, it's a special folder that Unity uses to have editor scripts if you want to do custom editor tools. So that's where I keep any scripts for custom editor tools, but I group my editor tools by module. So I try to keep the scripts organized in the editor folder. I'm not just throwing all the scripts together. I kind of have a general rule that there should be no loose files. Everything has a place. Everything should be organized. In the prefabs folder, I break that down into three subfolders: characters, props, and UI and background elements. The characters is your character, it's also your NPCs and your enemies, things like that. Your props is your items or maybe chests or any world items. UI and background elements is obviously your UI brought into prefabs, and it's also any empty game objects that you might be using as controllers that you drag into the prefabs as well. The resources folder is another special one by Unity. It will make it so that you can load things directly out of your editor from the resources folder. And I'm sure there's a lot of uses for that, but the best practical use that I've found is for loading data into custom editor tools. And if I make videos on doing custom editor tools, then I'll cover more about that there. So in your scenes folder, you have your scene assets, obviously, but I also have my scriptable object-based scene management assets. And those I will cover when I do my scene management video later. What I do is I use scriptable objects to extend the properties of my scenes so that I have more control over them when I'm loading them as partial scenes on the fly. Lastly, I have my scripts folder. And in my scripts folder, I break that one down like in the editor folder, I break it down by module. So anything that contributes to the same system, I'll have those be in the same folder. That way, code that contributes to the same system can stay grouped together. And then if you decide to export any plugins or anything like that, it won't have to pull all of your assets. It can pull things in specific modules. You could potentially reuse modules in later games. If you have systems that are totally independent, you might be able to reuse them, or at least readjust them for later games. So this is my quest to build the best game architecture that I can in Unity and C#. And the only way that I can do that is by you telling me things that I don't know, because that's really how I've gotten to where I'm at, is by scouring the internet and trying to find the best tips and tricks that I can possibly find and accumulating them together into one cohesive game architecture. So let's work as a community. Let's try to build the best game architecture that we possibly can. I'll come back and share everything that I learned and tips with you, and so that we can all have better games. So tell me what you're working on right now. I might be able to find things that would be most helpful for you to learn if I know what systems you're building right now. So tell me what systems you've built lately or what system you're building right now in the comments. Remember, clean code architecture and clean project structure help keep your project maintainable, and help makes it so that you can add more stuff later without the headaches. Stick around for my upcoming videos on how to use GitHub, how to set up a scene management system, a scriptable object-based event system, a game design pattern, character system, lots of stuff. There'll be tons more in this series. If you're looking forward to this series on game architecture, be sure to like this video, go to my channel and subscribe, and I will see you next time.